Hello, in this video we're going to see the VisualARQ space object features. So we will create the spaces of the ground floor. I'm going to work from the top viewport. I'm going to activate the cut plane in the ground floor, and now we will insert the spaces into these different rooms. There are different options by which we can insert the spaces. If we click on this arrow to see the different space commands, we can see that we create spaces from insert points, from curves, but also from surfaces. If we use the first option, we need to click inside an area that is totally enclosed by visual objects. Those objects include walls, columns, openings, or curtain walls. We click inside, the space will detect the surrounding area, and we just need to give a name, like room 1, and 1 style. That will define the information that will appear in the space level or the graphic attributes. We can do it for other rooms. I'm going to call this room 2. Room 3, and also toilet of the ground floor. When we select one of these spaces, we'll see that they have 2 control points. One is used to determine the position of the level, which by default always is located in the center of the area, that space, and another one determines in which room the space will calculate the parameters. That means that if we move this space from that point to another room, the level will indicate information of that other area. So if we copy this space from one point to another, if we copy it next to that point from another room, the space will be copied to another room, updating the space details. We can go now to the space properties and change that name. I'm going to insert a new space for that garage. And also another one for the hall. If the space is not detected, that means that there must be a gap at some point of the perimeter of this area. The room needs to be 100% closed within visual objects. If we take a closer look, we can see that the gap is just here. I'm gonna extend this curtain wall so it hits the wall, and now we can run the space command again. We can see that the area is detected now, and we can call this hall. We're going to change the space attribute later on from the space styles. In the case of spaces that are not enclosed by visual objects, for example, if we want to create the space of that Porsche, the only way to do that is by using the space from curves command. So I'm going to create first the curve. I need to generate that space. I'm going to enable the layer where I had these auxiliary curves. I'm going to hide momentarily all the visual objects. I'm going to work in wireframe mode, so we'll see everything. And I will just keep these curves to generate the one that I need for that Porsche. I'm going to isolate that selection. And from the top viewport, I'm going to run the curve boolean command. click on that area. So the curve is now created. Just notice that the position of that curve will also matter to display properly the space, because if that space was at the zero elevation, it wouldn't be displayed from the ground floor. Now we can hide this layer again. We can show everything back. So now from the top viewport, I'm gonna run the space from curves command. Select that curve, and I'm gonna call this porch. I'm gonna move the level to another position. Maybe just here. Within the space object features, we have an option to set an object that is not a visual object as a special element. That means that it would also be considered as a boundary element to calculate the space area. For example, imagine that we want to exclude the area underneath this ramp from that space. So I'm gonna isolate that space first. I will select all the spaces and select this one and hide the remaining ones. And now I'm gonna draw a polyline and I will define it as a special element. So I run this command, element set, select this curve, hit enter, and that area is removed from the space. So if we change the position of that polyline or to any other visual objects that define the boundary limits of a space, for example, if we extend this wall and make this toilet bigger, now we can select these two spaces, go to VisualARQ, Tools toolbar, and update them. So they will recalculate the information in their levels. Right now, we're seeing the spaces in plan view, but the spaces have also a representation in 3D. So spaces have a volume, and they are represented with these dashed lines in 3D. Right now, it is not possible to change that line type. Here, we can see also that we have this top face of the space's volume aligned with the slab of the first floor. So we can change the space's height in order to hide that. I'm gonna run the select space command, and from the properties, select the space and change the height to 2.0 millimeters. By default, spaces are created with the height of the level where they are inserted.